Hi learners, welcome to IoT supported hardwares on RFID. So RFID means radio frequency identification. So that's RFID. So what is how RFID is helpful for this IoT? So that also we'll see. So already we have discussed one topic on wireless sensor networks. So now we are going to see another topic on RFID. Similarly, we'll be seeing another two hardwares also. So what are the different hardware solutions available for IoT? Now RFID means, it stands for radio frequency identification. The acronym refers to small electronic devices that consist of a small chip and an antenna. So you can see a small chip and an antenna is there. So that's why in most of the ID cards of most of the universities and most of the companies, they have an RFID, and most of the books in the libraries, they too have an RFID here. So once you turn around the book, the first page, so there will be a small white color strip will be there. Inside there will be an RFID. And even nowadays cars, the car, so the automatic toll collection, suppose this is the front side of the glass, in the top of the glass there will be an RFID. So that means whenever it crosses the any toll booth, automatically the amount will be detected from this by reading this RFID device. So usually this chip will carry less than 2000 means just 2 kilobytes. So 2 KBs is very small data, just it can store about up to a data of 2 kilobytes. The RFID device serves the same purpose as a barcode or a magnetic strip on the back of a credit card or ATM card. So you can understand that the credit card and the ATM card, they doesn't need any power. So that means that no power is needed. That means they need not be externally powered through any batteries or anything. So they are a passive device. Similarly, RFID also passive device. So only the RFID reader needs a power, but not a tag. A tag doesn't need any power. And even you can see that in most of the shopping malls and shopping portals, so there you can have each and every product will be having a small RFID tag there. So that means that once you take the tag without any billing or anything, once you with the tag you can just take the product outside, it will alarm or it will beep. So that's how the RFID just is a passive device and it is very cheaper. The main thing is it is cheap, very cheap. So it provides one more thing, is it provides unique identifier. That means each and every RFID tag has a unique value. So we can able to program those unique value, and it will map the unique value with the existing thing. So let's say my employee ID is 10001. So the unique identifier is something. So for this identifier, this is the mapping. So I can able to do the mapping. So whenever this encounters, I can map that this person has come to the campus or anything. So that's how the way that we can process it. How the RFID works? So RFID belongs to a group of technologies referred to as automatic identification and data capture, AIDC. AIDC methods automatically identify objects, collect data about them, enter those data directly into the computer system with little or no human intervention. And RFID method plays radio waves to accomplish this. So simply it uses the radio waves. So that's why in most of the toll booths, so they ask you to paste the RFID tag on the center of the car glass, so that the vehicle glass, so that when the vehicle crosses, the radio waves can just scan the particular RFID tag and automatically will be billed. So just only thing is you have to reduce the number of speed, because the response time is a little bit nominal for RFID, so that once the vehicle crosses at a rate of, let's say, 60 or 70 km per hour, the RFID tag may not be, the reader may not read the tag. So that's why we have to have small speed. So that's why most of the vehicles, when they are moving in the toll gates, they ask to reduce the speed to less than 20 km per hour. So at a simple level, RFID system consists of three components. So RFID tag or a smart label, an RFID reader and an antenna. So there are three things. RFID tags contain an integrated circuit and an antenna, which are used to transmit data to the RFID reader, also called an interrogator. So they are called as an interrogator. They simply transmit the data to the RFID reader. The reader then converts the radio waves to a more usable form of data. Information collected from the tags is then transferred through a communication interface to a host computer system. So it can be transferred to a host computer system where the data can be stored in a database and analyzed at a later time. So that means that once the data is stored digitally on a particular computer platform, it can be processed and analyzed at a later point of time. So the tag is also composed of a protective material that holds the pieces together and shields them from various environmental conditions. So that's why most of the tag, let's say if you take a book, so let's say this is the back side of the book, so there's a small white strip and below that you will have the RFID tag. So maybe it's a small, you can see there's a light protruding from the white color paper here. So even if you just some weighing object has been put above the book, or just suddenly the book fell down, so there could be chances that the RFID tag or the smart label might be broken. So it is very thin or just seems to be a low grade plastic. So that's how the way we have to take care of this RFID tag and shields them from the various environmental conditions. So even there is any rain because of water going inside the tag, so there is all these issues are there. So the protective material depends on the application. For example, employee ID badges containing RFID tags are typically made up of durable plastic. The tag is embedded between the layers of plastic. So two layers of plastic, between the plastic, the tag is embedded. So maybe most of the identity cards, it will be having a plastic card. Nowadays we are getting plastic cards. So what happens is in the between two plastic cards, internally the RFID tag is placed so that it can be protected. There's a protective layer. RFID tags comes in a variety of shapes and sizes and are either passive or active. So there are some RFID tags, they are active also, and most of the RFID tags are passive. That means that they don't need any external power, but there are some are active too. So this is one RFID tags and smart label. RFID is one such kind of a great technology that can be easily adopted. So and it is globally accepted. So most of the places that we use RFID. So now RFID passive tags are mostly widely used as they are smaller and less expensive to implement. Passive tags must be powered up by the RFID reader before they can transmit data. Unlike passive tags, active RFID tags have an onboard power supply, example a battery, thereby enabling them to transmit data all the times. Smart labels differ from RFID tags in that they incorporate both RFID and barcode technologies. So that's what here they incorporate both barcode as well as RFID. Sometimes if RFID alone is there, so if you want to have another authentication, you can use barcode too. So smart labels can be encoded and printed on demand using desktop label printers, whereas programming RFID tags is more time consuming and requires more advanced equipment. So that's what the tags are very easy to program, whereas for processing we need more advanced equipment.